magfauna. So what is magfauna? Try to understand. We will not go that fast, we'll go a bit slowly, because there are so many things that I would like to discuss with you. I mean, to try and let us together understand. Fauna stands for, you know, the flora and fauna are the common words used. Flora means plant kingdom, fauna means animal kingdom. So magfauna means the intestinal flora and intestinal fauna is what we are referring to. The bacteria and fungi and the viri, all kinds of, you know, eukaryotes, all those microorganisms that are found in humans that are included in the category or categorized as fauna, intestinal flora and intestinal fauna. We are today discussing about the intestinal fauna, the microorganisms inside the guts, the human gut, and what we have, what role does Magnesa play in this regard. As you all may know, the human body contains trillions of specialized cells. Our body, human body, is made up of, it is estimated that 37.2 plus or minus 0.8 trillion cells that make up the human system. Cells join together to form tissues. Tissues join together to form organs. Organs together join together to form the body that we all know we have studied. So the cells are the fundamental building blocks in the humans. But we humans are not made up of only ourselves. There are maybe some studies say that there are 10 times more microorganisms in the human body. See, we have microorganisms in the gastrointestinal tract and the gut. You have it in your eyes, you have it in your skin, you have it in your lungs, you have it in your genitals. We have a symbiosis, a living together with the microbiota, we call it. Microbiota because it comprises of bacteria, fungi, viri, all kinds of things. So it is called microbiota. And if you would add up all those microorganisms that are living inside the body, inside and outside the body, that include your skin, it comes up to maybe sometimes 10 times the number of cells, that is around 300 million bacteria, viri, fungi are there in our body. It is, some studies say so. See, the collection of microorganisms in different area play a crucial role in helping our strength. See, all these microorganisms that are living in symbiosis, living together with the human cells or human body, once they are in good balance, in perfect balance, that is when we are all healthy. If there is any imbalance anywhere in the body with regard to the microorganisms, that include the bacteria, the virus, the fungus, the microorganisms, we will definitely have an imbalance, and that will lead to disease conditions, and that could even be depression, right? So you have bacteria in our eyes, you have lots and lots of bacteria in your skin. That's why we say if you would use very harsh antibiotic soaps and all, no, these good bacteria that are thriving in your skin will also die. And if they would die, the bad bacteria would thrive, causing skin conditions like dry skin, eczema, infections like that. So these good bacteria, bad bacteria, they compete for space not only in gut, not only in the stomach, small intestine, large intestine, they compete for space also in our skin, in our lungs, in our eyes, in our ears, right? At many places. So we are, our focus today, our focus is on the gut microbiota. That is the whole lot of hundreds of trillions of bacteria thriving in our stomach that play a very important role in the health and wellness of the gastrointestinal system in particular and the whole body. Because the bacteria have the caliber, the potential, the system, the mechanism to affect our brain. Not just the stomach, it can affect the liver, it can affect the brain. And once the brain is affected, or once the joints are affected, or once your blood vessels are affected, or the blood formulation is affected, these microorganisms can cause or exacerbate serious disease conditions like diabetes, arthritis, depression, Alzheimer's, you cannot imagine, because it is just like we are 37 trillion and they are 300 trillion. They are all living together inside the gut, here, there, and helping us actually. They are there in a symbiosis. They get their food and we get lots of nutrients from them. The human gut, studies shows that human gastrointestinal tract houses a vast collection of bacteria, a vast collection. There are lactobacillus, there are, bacillus, so at least 2,175 different species of bacteria are living in our stomach. And the thing is, research also suggested that the bacteria moderate the connection between the gut and brain. There is a connection between our gut and the brain that is moderated by the bacteria. The bacteria inside your gut, the bacteria inside your stomach, small intestine, large intestine, they can communicate with the brain in such a way through the enterous nervous system and other mechanisms that is what is eventually resulting in immunity, immune system. It had been found that there are around 2,172 bacterial species, right? There are 2,172 bacterial species in the human gastrointestinal tract. But some of these strains, like Escherichia coli, they cause diarrhea, vomiting. Some strains like Streptococcus aureus, they are resistant to antibiotics. So there are some species of bacteria that are harmful. There are some species of bacteria that are helpful. And there is a balance between these harmful and helpful bacteria in our gut. And if there happens to be an imbalance, if the bacteria would die, if they don't get the food, if they don't get a proper ambience, like, you know, when you are taking a lot of antibiotics, how can the bacteria thrive? They are all killing the bacteria. What is an antibiotic? It will kill the bacteria. It will kill both the good and bad bacteria. So the ambience problems are there. And there are other factors, like, you know, the bacteria has to get food. The bacterial food is what we call probacteria. In our mouths, there are 12 different species of bacteria, around 85 different types of bacteria are there in our mouth. You know, some of them are helpful, some of them are harmful. Scientists have now found that there is a relation, direct relation between diabetes, obesity, Parkinson's disease, depression, autism, etc. There is a direct relation between the bacteria in your stomach, the bacteria in your stomach, and the disease condition. Right? So the bacterial symbiosis inside the gut, inside the stomach, is not just a simple thing. It is very, very important, especially for ladies. We'll come to that. The interaction between the brain and the gut has been studied, for its complexities run deeper. It seems that mind, you know, our tension, our depression, lots of things are controlled by the bacteria. You may be wondering whether the bacteria can do it. Definitely the bacteria can do it. There are bacteria that are closely related to cats. Those bacteria that thrive comfortably inside the cat. If those bacteria happen to come to your body through the urine or through the cat drops, if it would enter your body, it can reach your brain and make you think mad. There have been instances where people driving their bike crazy. They drive so fast and make an accident. And once their brain is studied as to why people go so crazy, it had been found that this particular bacteria is living in the brain, in their brain, and this bacteria is prompting them to, take all sorts of risks, and they may even die. So bacteria, depending on where they are, they can help you, they can maintain the health, and they are very, very important when it comes to health and wellness. See, in diabetes, vitamin B is very important to control the diabetes. And the vitamin B is synthesized within our body, within our guts, by whom? By the bacteria. There are some bacteria who would synthesize this vitamin B and short-chain fatty acids. You know what is a fatty acid? It is an oil. Fatty acids, all oils, all fats are made up of fatty acids. Okay? Fatty acids are the building block of all fats, all oils. So you have different types of fats. You have coconut oil is a fat. Coconut oil is made up of medium chain fatty acids. So omega-3, black cumin seed oil is made up of long chain fatty acids. Or there are DHA, EPA. No, there are very long polyunsaturated fatty acids. So there are different types of fatty acids. Among them, the most interesting and the most important fatty acid for the yes. Knee problem? Someone had raised their hand. It seems. Any problem? Right. So we will go proceed. These vitamins, vitamin B can be synthesized by the bacteria only, and there are SFA, short chain fatty acids, that can be synthesized only by bacteria. You cannot get it from any seed like coconut oil or black cumin seed oil, flax seed oil, almond oil, jojoba oil, nothing like that. These short chain fatty acids are synthesized by the bacteria from the fiber we eat. When you eat rice or when you eat wheat or gehu or vegetables, there are fibers, indigestible things in that. Fibers are of two types, soluble fiber and insoluble fiber. Whether it is soluble or insoluble, human's digestive system cannot digest a fiber. These bacteria digest those fibers. Now, those fibers are the food for the bacteria. So the bacteria will digest those fiber. And eventually, they will synthesize short-chain fatty acids that are very important for our health and wellness. So I'm just trying to make you understand as to how important the bacteria, the good bacteria in our gastrointestinal system are. See, they can autoimmune conditions, inflammations. The bacteria, if there is a dysbiosis, that means there has to be a symbiosis, there has to be a balance between good bacteria and bad bacteria. And if there happens to be a dysbiosis, if the good bacteria, the bad bacteria would exceed, you have a disease condition. And the disease condition could be diarrhea, dysentery, arthritis, diabetes, Parkinson's, stress, autism, it can be anything. That is what we need to understand basically, right? It's not just a simple story. It is the basic thing about maintaining health. That is why fiber is a very, very important thing in our nutrition and diet. World Health Organization and the governments are allowing us to claim that if 35 grams of fiber a day can save you from diabetes and high cholesterol. How come these are happening? This fiber is the food of the bacteria, good bacteria in the stomach. And these good bacteria, they are capable of directly impacting our various disease conditions. The disease conditions, not just diseases, they can cause disease, they can also cause disease conditions. So what is a disease that is caused by the bacteria directly? As I told you, Escherichia coli, human excreta, it is there in the human excreta. Escherichia coli, Staphylococcus aureus, and there are bacteria called Hylobacterium pylori. This Hylobacterium pylori bacteria, it can cause, ulcers. So there are bacteria that can cause diseases. If you would kill the bacteria, the disease will go. And there are disease conditions where the bacteria are indirectly involved. Okay, diabetes is a disease condition. There is no bacteria directly involved in it. But the certain bacteria cause this diabetes, arthritis, Parkinson's, autism, memory lapse, all these things can be caused by bacteria. Not directly, but indirectly. That are called disease conditions. Diabetes is a disease condition. Arthritis is a disease condition. Heart problem is a disease condition. Parkinson's, Alzheimer's kinds of brain diseases are disease conditions. Try to just understand this. That's why we say in our disclaimer that this is not a product. For example, Macfona is not intended to treat, prevent, cure or diagnose any disease or disease condition. We speak it separately, right? So the link between our gut and the brain, hormonal, immunological and neurological via the central nervous system, there is a connection between our gut and the brain through the nervous system. It was there because the first time the brain was formed. Because when we were a zygote inside the womb of our mother, we did not have this kind of a brain, okay? It was a single cell. So that cell divided, and three tubes had formed initially. One tube became your blood vessel, one tube became your nervous system, and the third became your gastrointestinal system. That started with the mouth, ending with the anus. So there is stomach, there is small intestine, large intestine, liver, lungs, and pancreas. So many organs associated with the intestinal system. And this gut and brain, there is an axis called gut-brain axis. You know, in the event, you feel like a burning inside our stomach, a burning like thinking, and something is going to happen. The first sign comes from the stomach, not from the head. It comes from the stomach. So the primitive brain, first brain, fastest brain is in your stomach. And that is where all these bacteria are also residing. This bacteria can do many things. For example, a bacteria want to enter the bloodstream and cause a disease. If a bacteria want to thrive, they will make you stressed. If you are stressed up, what will happen? If you are stressed up, the permeability of intestinal lining will increase so that the bacteria can enter into the bloodstream and reach wherever. Otherwise, even when the bacteria are there in the stomach, it cannot enter into the bloodstream through the intestinal wall because it is very, very intact. So now what happens? The bacteria can make you stressful, right? These bacteria can make you stressful and it can enter into the bloodstream. It can go and cause diseases, right? So the immune system is controlled by these bacteria. One study, these foodborne bacterial pathogens affect the intestinal system, intestinal cranial nerve, that because there is a direct connection, between your liver and the brain. How do you feel hungry? The liver informs the brain that my glycogen level is going low. Through the vagus nerve, the liver will inform the brain my stock level of sugar is going down. So ask this guy to eat. So the brain will make you hungry, you will go and eat and it will get digested and liver level of glycogen goes up and you feel satiated. Now the liver informs the brain, okay, enough, I've got enough of glycogen, ask him to stop. So there is a continuous communication between all the cells and the brain, especially the gut cells and the brain. This affects the immune system, this affects the immunity. Currently the most important thing as far as human beings are concerned is immunity. We have to have the immunity to resist bacteria, virus, fungus, all kinds of microorganisms. And stomach is where, when you drink a glass of water, when you eat something from outside, hundreds of thousands of millions of bacteria are entering, reaching your stomach, okay? And these bacteria, these bacteria that are entering your stomach, they cause disease condition. They can cause disease condition. These bacteria are controlled. Originally, they are controlled and we are given the health by good bacteria. Out of these good bacteria, the most well-studied and the most important are the bifido and lactobacillus species of bacteria. Lactobacillus porogenes, bacillus closi kind of bacteria. What does this bacteria do? They have the ability to improve the psychiatric disorders like anxiety, depression, autism, obsessive compulsive disorder, memory abilities including spatial and short-term memory. So look at that. What this bacteria, what we are talking about? We are talking about the gut bacteria, the good bacteria in your and my stomach. And we should know that these good bacteria are of supreme importance. Don't think, because we are always thinking negative about bacteria, because we heard more about antibiotics, antibacterials than good bacteria. We are unaware of the good bacteria who are maintaining our health, right? So when we talk about bacteria, we use two terminology. One is probiotic and the other is prebiotic. Probiotic is the bacterial spore itself. It will directly it will bloom into bacteria. Prebiotic is a food for the bacteria. Actually, it is the fiber that can help the growth. It can help the bacteria multiply many times. They are called prebiotics. So you understand what is a prebiotic and probiotic? And probiotic, that means our bacteria, the gut bacteria, that what we are supplementing as MagFauna, they are defined as, what is a probiotic? Growth promoting factors produced by microorganisms that are called MagFauna. And these probiotics are also defined as organisms and substances with beneficial effects influencing the intestinal microflora. And prebiotics are also defined as a live microbial feed supplement which beneficially affect the host by improving its intestinal microflora. Right? Probiotics are also defined as a mono or mixed culture. It can be one bacterial spore like Lactobacillus. Sometimes the doctor prescribes, whenever he prescribes an antibiotic, the doctor will also prescribe a Bacillac along with it. That is back to Lactobacillus acidophilus, because doctor knows that this antibiotic will kill the good and the bad bacteria in your stomach, and that can cause serious health hazards. So doctor is supplementing the bacterial spore in the form of a capsule, maybe a billion spores of Lactobacillus acidophilus as Bacillac, right? And probiotics are also defined as a viable microbial food supplement which beneficially influence the health of the host. It is a microbial food supplement. What you are giving is bacteria, good bacteria. I'm giving you Lactobacillus acidophilus, for example. What do you get? You know, the most balanced food in the world is said to be Thayir Sadam and, you know, lemon pickle that you can found in Tamil Nadu. It is called curd rice and lemon pickle is supposed to be the best balanced food in the world. Why? Because this curd rice is fermented rice actually. And once it is fermented, it is a source of Lactobacillus. Lactobacillus acidophilus is one bacteria that every human being requires sufficiently. And it dies every day. So you have to supplement. That is where curd rice and the yogurt, all kinds of things come in. Yogurt contains lots and lots of. That is why if you go to Punjab, you know, that lassi. And wherever you go in India, wherever you go, you can see the one or other use of yogurt and, you know, fermented food, what you call pickle, achar, right? Lemon pickle, mango pickle, these are all fermented foods. Fermented foods, what do they contain? They contain some bacteria, Lactobacillus, that once given the proper ambience will multiply. So probiotics are also defined as a microbial dietary adjuvant. It is a dietary supplement which is comprising of microbes and beneficially affects the physiology by modulating the mucosal and systemic immunity by improving nutritional and microbial balance in the intestinal tract. Once it maintains the nutritional and microbial balance in the intestinal tract, it can modulate the mucosal and systemic immunity. What is the mucosa? Mucosa is the lining of the gastrointestinal tract and your respiratory tract. It is plenty, but the balance has to be there to control the bacteria, millions of bacteria, virus, fungus that enter the system when you inhale and when you drink a glass of water, when you eat something, when you talk to someone, when someone sneezes, someone coughs, right? All these hundreds of thousands of millions of bacteria can enter the system. It is estimated, some scientists say that the ratio of good bacteria and number of human cells is 1:1. Some say that it is 10:1. Against every single cell, you have 10 bacterial cells inside your system. And those bacteria also have a genome, and that genome is also part of your genome. It can affect your genetics, right? The human microbiota, which is made up of trillions of microorganisms that include bacteria, and there are bacteriophages in your stomach, viruses that eat upon the bacteria that are there in the stomach, right, in the gut. The microbial cells and their genetic material is called microbiome, and you know what is a genome. We have Mag Genomics, in which we are talking about 3 billion basic pairs, or we have only 21,000 genes, you know. We have only 21,000 genes in the whole. 21,000 genes describe what you and me are, and you have got another 300 trillion bacterial genes available. right? That is why these bacteria, these microorganisms are so very important for us. It's so very important that they are only 2-3%, right? They are only 2-3% of the whole body, but in terms of number, they are 10 times. The gut microbes of each individual is unique. Your microbe and my gut microbe structure is unique. You have a different count, I have a different count, you have a different formula, I have a different formula. So maybe that is why you are not diabetic when I am diabetic, you are arthritic, I am not arthritic, you have a heart problem, I don't have a heart problem. All these things are directly, and you have some psychological problems, someone is stressed up, some students are, they have learning disorder, some have autism, some are overly anxious. People have so many problems, you know. And all these are one way or other related or connected to your gut, and where the bacteria play a very important role. The microflora, that is why so many studies show that this microflora, the good bacteria inside your stomach, as well as the bad bacteria, they have a profound effect on the anatomical, physiological, and the immunity development of the host. So the bacteria, your bacterial format, as to what are all the types of bacteria that you have and what's the ratio, it has a profound effect on your immunity. And when you are stressed up, you know, all these bacteria, bad bacteria are charmed. They get an opportunity to conquer you when you are stressed up. That is why stress is always related to one or other disease. And the disease can be anything. The disease condition can be anything. Even those people who are affected by COVID-19 are the stressed up people. Because when you are stressed up, the immune system go and address the stress when this virus are attacking you and conquering you and killing you. So stress has got a direct impact on diseases and disease conditions. And as microbiome that who are living in your gut, they also have a profound impact on our health and healthful conditions, right? The indigenous microflora stimulate the immune system. Our immune system is stimulated by the good bacteria to challenge the bad bacteria, bacterial antagonism, right? To kill the bad bacteria. There are viruses who will kill the bacteria, eat the bacteria. There are good bacteria who will compete and kill the bad bacteria. This symbiosis has to be promoted. This is a non-theory. Every doctor knows, every doctor prescribes, the whole world knows that human gut is the best colony for the most interesting good bacteria. There are beneficial bacteria, you know, that save you, and there are bad bacteria that will cause food poisoning, and that maybe they can kill you, right? These probiotics, you know, world over, probiotics are approved. American FDA, it has given a GRAS status. If you would go to America, and there is a food drugs authority like your FSSAI or the drugs authority of India, that is the food drugs authority that controlled the foods and drugs in America, they had given a status called GRAS status. You know what is a GRAS status? Generally recommended as safe. Curcumin, if you would check in FDA, US FDA, they will say GRAS. They will show it as GRAS. That means generally recommended as safe. But it's not a simple certification, you know, it takes a long time, lots and lots of validations to give that status. These probiotics have that GRAS status in US. In European countries, the European Safety Authority, Food Safety Authority, EFSA, just like we have FSSAI, Food Safety Authority of India, in the European countries, it is QPS. Their standard, the status standard, what they have given is QPS, Qualified Assumption of Safety. That means these probiotics are safe for human consumption. It is in this backdrop we are introducing MagFauna, right? MagFauna is a probiotic supplement. MagFauna supplements two bacterial spores. One is Lactobacillus pyrogenes and the other is Bacillus clausi. And then you have ginger, black pepper, long pepper, ajwain, and hing. You know, ajwain is carom seeds and hing is asafoetida for those people who don't know this Hindi name. The rest everything is known to you. Lactobacillus pyrogenes, Bacillus clausi, ginger, black pepper, long pepper, carom seeds, and asafoetida. Right? These are the ingredients of this product. Lactobacillus porogenes, that is the prime, you know, that is a bacterial strain that is consumed extensively. This is the bacterial strain that you can find in your yogurt, curd, lassi, curd rice, all kinds of things. This bacteria, this good bacteria thrive. And when you consume it, and when you consume fermented foods like pickle, you get the benefit of it, right? Lactobacillus porogenes is a probiotic strain resistant to heat and gastric acid. Why Lactobacillus porogenes? There is heat outside, and there is gastric acid inside your stomach that contain so many acidic things like hydrochloric acid, it can kill almost any bacteria. This Lactobacillus porogenes can thrive. It can survive in that hydrochloric acid, in that gastric acid ambience, and go to the small and large intestine, right? It has to reach the large intestine where they reside and thrive and do the entire beneficial work for the body. And for that, they have to go through your mouth, stomach, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, and then large intestine. And anything get digested in the stomach because of the thanks to the hydrochloric acid. This poor Lactobacillus porogenes can resist this strain. As it goes in the form of a spore, the bacterial spore resists digestion by hydrochloric acid, and you get the benefit in your small and large intestine. You know, it is estimated that the average duration of time between oral consumption, you upon taking a magfona, within 4 to 6 hours, the bacterial spore given in the capsule will reach the large intestine and you start getting the benefit slowly. The advantage lies in their ability to germinate throughout the intestinal tract. As soon as they enter the small intestine, they start germinating. The count, we are giving 1 billion spores. You know, this 1 billion would become 10 billion or 100 billion as it run through the small intestine to the large intestine. It depends upon the ambience in your particular intestinal condition, right? However, they multiply. They multiply even before they reach the large intestine. This Lactobacillus porogenes improve the cholesterol profile. When your cholesterol level is high, because its effectiveness in modifying lipid metabolism, these bacteria have the ability to modify the metabolism. That what is metabolism? Breaking down of lipids and building up. You break down the lipid that you have eaten, and then you use it in the body, which is called the building up process. This cholesterol lowering properties occur because they can assimilate and integrate the cellular structure of cholesterol by blocking cholesterol in the intestine and inhibiting the enzyme HMG-CoA. There is an enzyme called HMG-CoA. This HMG-CoA, whatever medicine that you take for statins, you know, cholesterol lowering called statins, if you would check, you will know that it is an HMG-CoA reductase inhibitor. Cholesterol can be synthesized in the liver, by the liver, only with the help of HMG-CoA reductase enzyme. Just like the medicine resists, when you take a statin to lower your cholesterol, it is only inhibiting this enzyme. Similarly, this good bacteria also can inhibit the enzyme and see that your cholesterol lipid profile doesn't go harmful, beyond control. Lactobacillus porogenes contribute to a change in the intestinal environment to support all of the intestinal flora. The advantage why we are giving Lactobacillus porogenes, because it has got it supports the all the bacteria. I told you there are around 2000 plus different species of bacteria. Some say that there are 85, some say that there are 100 or 1500. Whatever it is, Lactobacillus porogenes support all the good bacteria. It has got that property one. It has been repeatedly observed, right? The positive effect of Lactobacillus porogenes, Bacillus coagulans in our magfauna on gastrointestinal disorders, local inflammation. You can have so many gastrointestinal problems, metabolic and inflammatory problems such as arthritis. What is a metabolic problem? Diabetes is a metabolic disorder. Inflammatory problem, arthritis is an inflammatory problem. There are so many problems that this bacteria can help control in the gastrointestinal tract, gastrointestinal disorders. I have a cousin, and I know few, very many people who just, they dress up, they tie their necktie, everything, before they go out and get into their cab, they come back and go to the toilet for once, and then only they will go. Some kind of an irritable bowel syndrome. It is an inflammatory problem. People feel like before you come to stage to talk about something, you feel a burn. You feel like going to the toilet. These are all inflammatory conditions inside the stomach. Lactobacillus sporogenes supports, right? Lactobacillus sporogenes is what I told you, irritable bowel syndrome. People feel like pain, there is a blotting, there is heartburn, people feel like going to the toilet often. They feel that the bowel emptying had not taken place properly. These are all called part of IBS. It is called irritable bowel syndrome. Lactobacillus sporogenes can help. By averting conditions in Crohn's disease. Crohn's disease is an autoimmune disorder that affects the gastrointestinal tract, a very painful condition. Lactobacillus sporogenes, good bacteria, can help. It can help prevent diarrhea. This bacterial spray can help prevent diarrhea, flatness, bloating and gas. You know, it all happens due to fermentation. This bacteria can help. It can help improve hyperlipidemia. That means lipid profile, cholesterol level can be modulated in immunomodulatory activity by preventing or treating autoimmune diseases such as osteoarthritis, rheumatoid arthritis. These autoimmune disorders where these bacteria, this good gut bacteria can help, right? They pop up with viral attacks such as influenza. When you are attacked by virus like COVID-19 or influenza, your gut bacteria, gut biome has to be intact. It has to be balanced. Otherwise, body will not be able to fight with the virus. Simple. It can enhance the athletic performance because it has the ability to reduce muscle damage markers, increase recovery. Athletes require this good bacteria. And for women's health, administered topically for women's health, women require a lot of lactobacillus because the good bacteria in the vaginal tract that protect the vaginal tract, the uterus, the baby, everything is this good bacteria called Lactobacillus sporogenes that is there in lactic acid. Now, the other bacterial spore, what we have included in this product in MacFauna is Bacillus floci. This is another bacterial spore. This is aerobic spore forming bacterium. Why we have included Bacillus floci, right? The reason for including Bacillus floci is that the reason for including even acid attack because in a or a tablet. There are antibiotics given extensively to chicken, mutton. So you get your antibiotics from your milk, right? The milk you drink is flooded with antibiotics. The chicken, the mutton, the meat, vegetables, medicines. Doctors are prescribing antibiotics. It is estimated that by the year of 2050, every year, antibiotic resistance will kill a minimum of 1 crore people globally. Now you look at, you compare it with the current COVID situation, how many people have died so far? How many will die in a year's time? 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs, 30 lakhs? And think about this antibiotic resistance, which is going to kill a minimum of 1 crore people every year. Hundreds of thousands would die because of this antibiotic resistance. So antibiotics, this is the harm what antibiotic does. Antibiotics are also killing. When you are drinking a glass of water, when you are eating some chicken, broiler chicken, when you are buying and eating some meat, mutton, beef, pork, whatever, you are also ingesting a lot of antibiotics. These antibiotics will kill the good bacteria and the bad bacteria maybe in your stomach. Once the good bacteria are killed in your stomach, you know you are going to have emptying problems. Depending on your genomics, depending on your genetics, it can be diabetes, it can be arthritis, it can be another heart problem, it can be it can be a gut brain axis problem like stress, anxiety, your neuropsychosis, it can be anything. And you and me can't help. We only can take a preventive action. See, Magnesa is all about inspiring people to be well. We are not into any sickness industry or treating. We are asking, requesting people to be well, inspiring them to be well. I'm just sharing some information and I'm inspiring you to be well. You should know that you are facing a problem. When you are giving a glass of water to your son or a daughter, you should know that probably that milk contains antibiotics, and those antibiotics are going to kill the good bacteria in my son's or my daughter's stomach. I need to do something about it, right? And when you are taking a chicken or a mutton, don't think that when you are cooking, all these things would die. No. It wouldn't. These are spores. These spores wouldn't die. It can withstand any situation, right? So antibiotics is there in your diet. It is going to have a big impact. Take care. That's all we have to tell you about this. I think you are a bit clear about the what are the probiotics, okay? Probiotics are the bacteria, the good bacterial spores that we give. In Mac Fauna, there are two probiotics. One is Lactobacillus sporogenes 1 billion spores, and the other is Bacillus cloci 1 billion spores. Both Lactobacillus and your Bacillus cloci, both can withstand, as they are in spore form, they can withstand the acidic ambience in the stomach, and Bacillus cloci go beyond to resist the antibiotics. So antibiotics cannot kill this good bacteria, so it can take care of problems like, you know, diarrhea, your ulcer kind of, you know, gastrointestinal problem. See, what I'm trying to tell you is, please, even though we have taken special care to see that this product supports the gastrointestinal system and digestion very well, do not think that this is a digestive thing. If you have some asthma, some asthma problem, arthritis, diabetes, any problem, even sometimes stressed up, anxiety, fear, try good bacteria, right? Try probiotic Mac Fauna. Now, there are other ingredients in this that you know very well, so I don't require much of your time to talk to you about this product. One is Practispemum Ami. It is called Ajwain. But you know Ajwain, no? It is very common, we all know. We use it regularly in our diet at home, so it is a food. It has a powerful antibacterial, antifungal property, right? There are two compounds in it. One is thymol, the other is carvacrol. This thymol and carvacrol in Ajwain, it has got antibacterial and antifungal property. So it will kill the bad bacteria. It will not kill the good bacteria. It selectively kills the bad bacteria and supports the probiotics what we have given in the form of Lactobacillus sporogenes and Bacillus cloci. It kills the very dangerous bacteria, very harmful bacteria like E. coli, Escherichia coli, that is commonly found in human excreta, and Salmonella. These are all, the Salmonella is there, it comes to you as a food poison. Sometimes, you know, you take some food from outside and you get severe dysentery, you get hospitalized, sometimes people die. It is due to this bacteria called Salmonella. This Practispemum Ami had shown the potential, the proper ability to kill such bacteria. And it is used traditionally, it's an important remedial agent in flatulence, in gas, you know, like, you know, people feel their stomach is so full, gas, all kinds of problems. We use Ajwain, and it has got antifungal, antioxidant, antimicrobial, anti-noiseptic, that is, it will not communicate the pain to the brain, cytotoxic, hypolipidemic, it helps lower the fat, hypertensive, antispasmodic. That's why, you know, at homes, we used to boil drinking water with some Ajwain in it and drink it, because it has got a wide variety of health benefits. One test tube study observed that carom seeds are more effective against multi-drug resistant strains of bacteria. See, I told you that 1 crore people would die in 2050 every year due to drug resistance. Today, the problem is most of the bacterial strains are multi-drug resistant. There are so many antibiotics like, you know, ciprofloxacin, ofloxacin. There are so many antibiotics like ampicillin, cloxacillin, ciprofloxacin, ofloxacin. They are all resistant. One bacteria is resistant to all the strain. That is a danger. When you have an infection, when you go to the hospital, when the doctor is trying to give you an antibiotic, you are resistant. The bacteria withstands and you may die. The advantage with Ajwain is that it can kill those multi-drug resistant strains of bacteria and fungi. That's why we had been traditionally using it, and we are providing it here also. The next ingredient is Asafoetida. Asafoetida, you know, Hing. think it can help in IBS, irritable bowel syndrome characterized by flatulence, pain, bloating, gas, constipation, diarrhea, all these things, you know, sometimes asthma. These are there in related to gastrointestinal issues. Asafoetida can help. It is rich in antioxidant. You know what is hing? It gives a flavor. It gives a taste called umami. It has got digestive enzyme. It can boost the digestive enzyme, especially bile. Right? This hing, what it does, it increases the digestive enzymes, especially bile. With bile only, you and me can digest fat. If there is a problem with bile as a digestive juice, you know, fat cannot be digested. So you will have problems when you take non-veg or you take oils. And asafoetida is anti-inflammatory, antioxidant, antibacterial, antifungal. That's why it is there traditionally in your diet. You just think about it. Why hing is there traditionally in our diet? Because it has got all these properties. And the third, and it is a combination, trigadu. Trigadu is a medical and herbal and a culinary combination. We use it at home. It is being used in medicine. It is used in Ayurveda. It is a combination of ginger, black pepper, and long pepper. 33.33, 33.33, 33.33, right? In equal combination, they are blended to form trigadu. This ginger, black pepper, and long pepper work in synergy. They work. What is synergy? Synergy is 1 plus 1 is equal to 3. 1 plus 1 is 2. That is what arithmetic, when these two ingredients work together to give an additional benefit, it is called synergy. So these three ingredients, 1 plus 1 plus 1 is not 3, it is 4 or 5. So they act synergistically for more efficient digestion in the stomach while promoting proper bile flow. I told you proper bile flow is very important for digestion. And healthy detoxification and fat metabolism. Detoxification is removing. That is, you know, you are correcting the toilet habit, you know, removing the waste matter from the large intestine, cleansing the colon, removing the toxic waste from the colon, improving the bile flow for proper digestion, and correcting the fat metabolism. These are all what this trigadu does. Is experimentally, the advantage is trigadu is supportive for the liver. It protects the liver against the activity of liver damage. Whatever damage that happens to the liver due to digestive system disorder, the ingredients in pipali, you know, marija, that is called long pepper. It protects the ingredients in trigadu. It protects the liver against viral hepatitis. You know, hepatitis is a viral infection. So liver is very important in digestion. And you know what is ascites? Sometimes people, their stomach will be very big. It is called ascites. And trigadu can help in that condition also, to help reduce the weight, to help the liver. And bile, you know, bile is a very important digestive juice secreted by the liver. Liver, if something happens to liver, bile secretion will be affected and you can have heartburn, you can have any digestive problem. So this most important ingredient of trigadu, ginger. Ginger has got antibacterial. Ginger, you know, we use ginger extensively in the event of indigestion, gas and all. We all know as to how important ginger is, because ginger can kill the bad bacteria and support the good bacteria. So you have a formulation here. You have a formulation here. That formulation, as we all know, that formulation comprises of these ingredients. One is Lactobacillus sporogenes, which is a probiotic, right? Then you have Bacillus clausii, which is a probiotic, right? There are two probiotics, and the advantages are that these two probiotics can survive the acidic environment in the stomach. It can withstand the hydrochloric acid in the stomach, one. And then what happens? It can thrive right from the intestine. It can start thriving right from the intestine. So this product, in terms of probiotic, this is very advanced. This is a combination, synergistic. Lactobacillus sporogenes and Bacillus clausii. Don't worry about the name and all that, you can learn later on. Just know that there are two ingredients that are very important, right? Two probiotics that improve your gut health significantly. And there are five other things. One is your hing, right? Ferula. Then you have ajwain, Trichostemum ami. And then you have ginger, long pepper, and black pepper. It comes as 500 milligram capsule. You can take one capsule in the morning and one capsule in the evening, for because I told you it takes 4 to 6 hours for the bacterial spore to reach the stomach and start food. Once it is stabilized, you will feel the difference as to what happens when we have this gut bacteria properly balanced, what we call a symbiotic stage. When there is a symbiosis of the good and bad bacteria in the stomach, you and me are safe in terms of, not only in terms of many health conditions, serious health conditions like diabetes, arthritis and all, we are also immunized. We are inoculated with immunity to combat many a bacterial and viral infection. This is not a medicine, not intended to treat, prevent, cure or diagnose any disease. This is just a dietary supplement. This is approved by US FDA as it had been given a GRAS status. You know what is a GRAS status? I told you, GRAS status stands for generally recommended as safe. It is approved by European Food Safety Authority. It is approved by Food Safety Standards Authority of India. This is a food supplement, right? So try to understand the product. Now the products are reaching all the branches, MCPs, and you can place order for the product. Introduce the product. This is first of its kind from Magnesa. We are entering a new arena where you will have a range of products that will be addressing the basic fundamental bacteria and the guts, right? So we'll talk about it on a later date about the newer introductions to this category. Try to understand. Magfauna, thank you very much for a very patient listening. Good night, all of you.